Hello everyone, hope you're having the greatest of days today. Welcome to the Film Insight channel. For today's video, we're going to cover some more of the worst bars to be featured on Bar Rescue and reveal how they're doing now. So, sit back, relax, and without further ado, let's get right into the content, guys. Marley's on the Beach. For a Season 3 episode, John Taffer heads over to Warwick, Rhode Island to rescue a bar called Marley's on the Beach from closure. Owned by a man named Kevin, who previously worked in IT, he purchased the bar with the help of his wife, Michelle. Serious about succeeding, Michelle put in close to $200,000 of her retirement savings into the business, but she would soon understand that this was a big waste. Since the bar was close to a famous chowder house called Iggy's, the couple thought that they would magically inherit some of their success. Not only were they very wrong about this, but they received a bad reputation instead since their food was god-awful. Being $250,000 in debt and losing more than $4,000 a month, the owners called out to Taffer for some aid. Upon his eventual arrival with his experts, they decided it would be an interesting experiment to send in 200 people to see how the staff would react. Aside from the kitchen not being ready when this all happens, there's only one bartender present, which is why it was disastrous. Customers had to wait close to an hour for their orders to be fulfilled, which is not surprising, so Taffer headed inside to confront the owners. Reprimanding them for being incapable of pleasing their customers, Taffer heads into the kitchen with expert chef Brendan Collins soon after to watch them cook in action. Due to the fact that the kitchen wasn't keeping track of the temperature of some of their ingredients, they were forced to throw out a bunch of food. Angry with the criticisms being made, a chef named Diana immaturely abandons her post and drives home. Leaving and returning the following day, the famous rescuer holds a staff meeting and is surprised to see Diana back, who is apologetic about leaving. Most of the staff think that she's disruptive and terrible at her job, so she's asked to leave, but manages to convince the management to give her a second chance. Next, it comes to Taffer's attention that Kevin was really only supposed to act as a silent partner, but was too stubborn to listen, so he's asked to step back and let Michelle take over. Training the staff later on, the bar rescue host holds a stress test soon after and is only left feeling disappointed by how sluggishly they work. At the very least, Diana proved herself to be useful since she was making quality food at a good pace. Fast forward to near the end of the episode, after the bar's weak links were sacked and the staff was trained even further, Taffer was finally ready to move into the renovations. Renaming the place to St. Michelle's Beach Club, the famous rescuer also introduced two new concepts to the bar, being a happy hour for the older folk and a nightclub for the younger crowd. On the outside, the patio was completely changed to include fire pits and chaise lounges, while the inside was given a nautical theme. Weeks after the taping of this episode, the owners reported that the food and drink sales increased by 30%, which is great. It seems like Kevin listened to Taffer's advice and sat back as a silent partner, which helped out his marriage greatly. They did end up changing the name to Marley's Beach Club since they didn't really like the one Taffer proposed. Ultimately though, the bar closed down in November of 2013 since the owners were going through some personal issues and couldn't focus on the business anymore. Sand Dollar. In another Season 3 episode, John Taffer heads over to the failing Sand Dollar to bring it back on its feet. Opened in 1976, it was popular for over 3 decades but ultimately closed down in 2006 due to a drastic decline in customers. It remained closed right up until 2012 when a woman named Lisa Guerna decided to buy the place with the money she borrowed from her ex, Dr. Paul Wiltz. Becoming business partners and joint owners, they decided that it would be a good idea to revive the bar by hosting live blues shows. However, this decision seemed to only be attractive to an older demographic, so their customer base was pretty small. What's worse, the bar staff seemed to despise the owners since Guerna is negligent and Wilkes drives female customers away. Unsure of how to move forward, the owners desperately called out to Taffer and his team for some guidance. When he finally arrives with his experts, they can't seem to tell if the place is a bar since the sign doesn't make it clear. Watching through CCTV cameras, they point out that the interior looks run down, disgusting, and old. Hoping to get a better idea of the customer experience, Taffer sends in his wife Nicole with a friend for recon. The two order a simple screwdriver and a lemon cup, which the bartender hilariously makes in a plastic cup. Despite the fact that they ordered a screwdriver, which is very simple to make, they instead received the cranberry and vodka that was way too strong. Noticing that the friends were frustrated with the drinks that they received, Wilkes apologizes to the women and asks them to give the bar a second chance by ordering a different drink. Ordering a Sex on the Beach cocktail, Wilkes inappropriately asks them for bags of sand, then goes on a tangent about how he wants to touch them. Justifiably, Taffer gets riled up about the owner's creepy behavior and rushes inside to escort his wife out. Despite the fact that the bar rescue host didn't want to save the bar anymore, he came back the following day to give the owners a second chance. Embarrassed, Wilkes apologizes to Nicole for his unacceptable behavior and reveals that he'll do or change anything to help Lisa succeed. Touched by this, Taffer agrees to help and brings in his experts immediately after to inspect the round. After Taffer gets the bar cleaned, expert mixologist Jen Jay teaches the staff how to make a collection of drinks, including a lemon cup. Holding a stress test soon after, Taffer is utterly unimpressed with how incompetent and sluggish the staff is. Aside from the Sand Dollar team needing a lot more training, the blues music wasn't a hit with the customers, so it had to go. Fast forward to near the end of the episode, after everyone was brought up to a competent level, the place was renamed to Bar 702 and was given an upscale look. Thanks to Taffer's help and the owner's willingness to change, the bar was met with tons of local traffic after the episode aired. Although it was purchased in May of 2014 by someone named Brooke Alexander, who always dreamed of having a bar in Vegas. Staying open until November of 2019, the building was sold to a new owner who renamed it to the Miracle on Spring Mountain. Interestingly enough, Wilkes decided to file a lawsuit against Taffer for attacking him during the episode, but it didn't really go anywhere. The Los Angeles Brewing Company. As our final entry, we're going to discuss a bar that John Taffer attempted to rescue called the Los Angeles Brewing Company. Purchased by Richard Ramos for $250,000 back in 2012, he had high hopes for the business's potential. In a way, he wasn't wrong for thinking this, since the place was making a whopping $2 million a year. However, after Richard got caught up in a rough legal dispute, he lost tons of money and was forced to fire his entire staff. Having no other options, the owner decided to hire his family members for help and slash his inventory in half to save money. According to the owner's nephew Abel, working with Richard is an absolute nightmare since he doesn't listen to anyone's feedback. It's for this very reason that the business is $1 million in debt and losing close to 15 grand a month. Worried that his business would crash and burn, Richard called out to Taffer for some professional help. Upon his eventual arrival with Maria Menounos, a famous television host, they point out that the bar is missing most of its beer tap handles. Unlike in previous episodes, Taffer heads inside with Menounos and a group of other people to do some recon. Asking how many beers they have available, they only have 18, which is 82 less than is advertised on the sign outside. Ordering every beer they have available, the famous rescuer calls out the bartender for pouring the drinks incorrectly and gets them to do it properly. Aside from the beer tasting incredibly bitter, the food they ordered was dry and tasteless, which was incredibly disappointing. Telling the owner to shut the place down, the bar rescue host gathers the staff together to discuss the business's issues. Most think that Richard should sell the business, since he doesn't understand how to run a bar and uses the family's money to keep the place afloat. Since there was a lot to work on, Taffer decided to start by first bringing in his experts to train the staff on how to properly pour drinks and cook delicious barbecue. Throughout this process, one of the experts, being Neil White, noticed that the beer taps were disgusting and requested to peek inside the systems. Horrified, White found mold growing in the beer lines, which was a clear sign that they were scarcely cleaned. To make matters even worse, the kitchen was covered in grime and debris, which would need to be cleaned before they can run a stress test. Clearly disappointed with how far his bar has fallen, Richard promises to step up for the sake of his business. After probably having one of the shortest and most disastrous stress tests in bar rescue history, Taffer gives the owner a choice to continue with the bar or sell it after the remodel. Surprisingly, this rescue was one of the most expensive Taffer was a part of, which is painful to hear when you realize how things turned out. Not even 2 months after the bar rescue team left, the place was shut down and put up for sale for $500,000. Even if the business did get a boost for the first few weeks, Richard was still hopelessly in debt, so it was bound to fail. Well, that'll be all for today's video here on the channel. I do hope you enjoyed, and if you did, be sure to drop a massive like down below and comment your thoughts. Subscribe for more content like this, and turn on those sweet bell notifications for instant access to our content. Have a good one, guys.